Good afternoon, everybody. Silver Dragon here, coming at you with some more From the Depths. Going to be doing another tutorial here today. This one is going to be focused on the lasers, or I should say the custom lasers in the game. So let's go ahead and hop into the vehicle designer here quickly. And I will show off the lovely little platform I have set up here. Now, load vehicle, laser testing platform. There are three types of lasers that we'll be exploring today. Continuous beam lasers, pulse beam lasers, and then finally laser missile defense, which is kind of a separate system to this whole thing. Now, I'm going to start from the beginning here and create a little laser beam right here. We put a wooden block down to raise it up off the ground. Now, if you go into build menu B and then E to pull up the tab menu here, go into custom cannons, and under multipurpose laser, we will find our laser blocks. Now, as you can see, there's quite a bit to it. There's just options everywhere. And I will start to hopefully cover all of those. Now, first things first, you want to start off with is a laser coupler. This is the system that the laser cavities attach to and create the laser beam that we'll be firing. Now, with the coupler, the laser cavities need to be set up behind them, facing backwards like this. You cannot build it facing forward or from the sides. It doesn't do anything. It has to connect to this little piece here and go backwards. And actually, that's too many. I'm only going to do two of these, I guess, for now. Now, the cavity is essentially the power of the generated laser. So, if this thing was connected up, it would say 200 power. So, each one of these you place is going to give you a storage of 100 power. You can kind of think of this as the ammo rack for this weapon, in a way. Next, we need the item that's going to restore the energy to this by using the power of our engines. That would be the laser pump. These can be connected to the sides, top, or bottom, which is why I raised it up, of the device. They could also place it on the back as well, honestly, but we have other uses for that, so I'm going to avoid that at the moment. We now essentially have a laser beam. Just with this, we have a laser beam, even though it doesn't show it yet. Now, in order to take the laser generated by these two cavities here and turn it into something we can use, we need to grab the multipurpose laser block. This takes the laser from any coupler attached to it, either by just direct connection or from connectors or other means, and weaponizes it. So we now have a continuous wave laser of 1 damage and 1 armor penetration. The multipurpose laser block adds 1 AP by itself automatically, and an approximate range of 6. Now, in and of itself, we now have our laser being produced, armed, and now we need something to fire it from. That would be the laser combiner. It takes the now weaponized laser and then allows us to fire it using either the laser steering optics, which will help increase the range and accuracy of our weapon, or our laser steering optics. Laser optics increase the range and accuracy, and laser steering optics give us a greater field of fire. So let me create 3 of those. So we now have, if I go down here, a constant beam laser. Now, this is a very weak laser that you can fire. Actually, look at the range. You can barely even see it in the water here. So yeah, this is pretty much the weakest kind of beam laser you can do. Honestly, if you want to, you can. If you were to make a very powerful one, it might be effective for a couple of different things. But generally speaking, you want to make a pulse laser. In order to do that, we again go to our laser coupler build, go into the E menu, and we want the laser Q switch. You place this on the coupler and it converts a beam from all connected cavities from a continuous wave to a pulsed firing beam. So we now go from 1 damage to 40 damage. And if I start firing this thing now, you can see that it's a bit different. Let me scroll here. You see it's now firing a concentrated pulsed beam for this system. Now, if I add more Q switches on it, let me actually add 2 more. You can see that it greatly increases the fire rate. However, that also lowers the overall damage that it's doing. So it's really, you gotta decide what you want to do with this. Do you want a slow firing, you know, powerful laser, or a fast firing, weaker laser? It's up to you what you decide for that. Now, question is, how do we make this stronger? Well, there are 2 more things that, and the reason why I left the back here free, that we can attach to the back of the chamber here, of the laser cavity. That they are the frequency doubler and the laser destabilizer. The laser destabilizer itself just base increases damage, essentially. The frequency doubler increases armor penetration of the cavity, or of the laser. Now, let me go ahead and add on the laser destabilizer. So currently we have 17 damage. If I add one of these guys on, we now have 34 damage. And now it's 51 damage, and so on. If I add on a couple of frequency doublers, we go from one armor penetration to now 3 armor penetration, and a pretty decent approximate range. So we now have a rapid-firing, pretty decent weapon here. Now, along the lines of these destabilizers here, ignoring the frequency doublers, which are just for armor penetration, so I'm going to ignore them completely for now. If I go over to my testing platform here, I did end up trying a bit of an experiment. Essentially, I was trying to determine whether or not having a longer pump stack here, like this one right here in front of me, and fewer destabilizers, or a shorter pump stack and more destabilizers would give more damage for space. Because you can see these weapons are both the exact same length. The only difference being that one has more energy, so more stored power, for it for the beam itself, whereas the other one just, well, it does not. It only has three of these, so it's 300. So it's half the amount of energy stored to be fired in this weapon. So the question is, what is the power difference between doing these? Well, 155.8, 155.8. There is no difference in the amount of space to power. So essentially it seems like it's almost best only to even put one destabilizer on the end of this thing. Unless you get to the end of a ship and you have more room but not enough room for another, you know, adding all these laser pumps to it, I would definitely say, yeah, you're gonna want more pumps than the destabilizers themselves. I've been kind of debating about that for a while, so it's a good thing I finally experimented and figured that out. Now, moving on, as I mentioned before, you can connect multiple of these stacks to a multi-purpose laser block in order to increase the power. Right here is such a system where I had a bunch of these connector blocks set up that are transferring the power from the couplers on either side to this multi-purpose laser block and then firing it out. Now, you could actually have this, you know, stacked up, down, wherever, going sideways, you know, however you want to set this thing up. It's just one other way you could possibly connect all of these up and then send the power to the multipurpose laser block in order to strengthen the power of the beam. Another way you can transmit the power from the couplers to a multipurpose laser block and connect or weapon that you have stored on the complete other side of the vehicle would be these laser transceivers, which you can find, laser connector is right under the Q switch, and the laser transceiver is off on its own right here. Now, let me go ahead and disconnect this. The laser transceiver just sends the power of the beam directly through any object, so I could place blocks in between us, and it would go right through to the multipurpose laser block where it's armed and then sent out. Now, you can see right here the reason I disconnected all this. If you have a laser transceiver system set up, you have everything set up, but you do not connect it to the multipurpose laser block, these beams will not connect to each other. They won't transmit power because there's nothing that's arming it or nothing requiring it. But the moment that you actually connect it up to that, you can see that the beams will connect and suddenly it will send the power through and arm our weapon. Also, apparently, I do not actually have a Q switch on this thing. So it's a continuous wave laser. Now, the question is, how can we take this system and turn it into a bit of a turret setup? Well, I have that set up right here, essentially. So I take the same kind of pump stack I have with a bunch of destabilizers, some frequency doublers, set up to a couple of Q switches, which is then transmitted to a block underneath a turret. Now, let me actually go build here so we can take a look at it. So, I'm just using the multi-purpose laser block right here, so it connects directly to it. There's no, you know, that's the one thing about From the Depths. You can't really do anything wrong other than it just not working. You know, the design you make for whatever you decide to do with it, if you want to use connectors, if you don't want to use connectors and just want to use the block itself, you can do that. You know, it's just whatever you want to do with it. Anyway, regardless, So it's taking the power from the cavities, transmitting it here, arming it, and then sending it up to the actual turret. Now, some people have said that, or at least thought, that you could actually have it sent to this base and it would function. That doesn't work. So my solution in order to get this weaponized turret is I use a precision turret that keeps it stable, doesn't go, you know, back and forth and all around, which would probably cause the laser beam to disconnect and it would essentially wouldn't function. So use a precision turret for this. And then you take the laser connectors here. Let me actually just go ahead and click this, since for some reason it's not showing it. Probably because I'm not actually on the turret itself. There we go. Now it'll show up properly. So we have these laser connectors in a C-like formation with a laser transceiver pointed down towards the connecting block here. That is connecting them up and allowing the energy to transmit to the weapon, which we can now hop up here. Whoop! Which I can now aim and fire at will. And that is essentially one way to set up a turret like this. You could also, if you really wanted to, I suppose... Oh, that's the wrong button right there, my bad. Alright. Let me go, new objects, turret, precision turret. If you really wanted to, I suppose, you could hook up everything to the actual system itself. Let's go laser connectors. You know, you could have something like this, where you have laser couplers. You can even hide this underneath the bottom of the ship, so that the top will turn and these will be connected underneath it. You wouldn't be able to make much in the room for space with this, which is why I use my system of transmitting the power. But yeah, you could do something like this, and they'll all transfer into the center. Then we have the multipurpose laser block, and up top here, maybe we have the laser combiner attached to it. So you could do a system like this, where you have everything literally attached to the turret itself. But I really like having, you know, large chambers somewhere else on the ship with laser pumps, sending dedicated beams to wherever it needs to go, and then transmitting that to the turret. It's, you know, it's better for a space kind of thing, essentially. And that pretty much covers how to set up laser turrets. Lasers themselves for either the continuous beam or the pulsed beam, which is my preference. Type of systems. That leaves us with one last type of laser system, and that would be the laser missile defense. Now, likewise with this, you can transmit the power to it from even this system if I wanted to use this for both the weapon and the laser missile defense. I could simply just go, I could simply go laser transceiver, and the power is now connecting and hooking up to this. So you don't need to create a separate system for this, but I have anyway just to show it off. Now, the laser missile defense is in the bottom right corner. It may be read it out for you. You need to unlock this by playing a story mission and completing it. So go ahead and do that. Now there's two parts to the laser missile defense. One is right here, which is this device I'm looking at right now. The other one is in the AI core, which we'll be covering in a second. Actually, I may as well just look at it right now. AI, the missile warner. Now, going back to the actual... Here we go. The laser missile defense works pretty much like a regular laser. It'll essentially detect enemy missiles being fired at us, and it will fire laser beams at them to attempt to destroy them. Obviously, the more damage you have, the better, you know, it's going to do that job. Let me actually add a couple more destabilizers on here and some frequency doublers to increase the damage of this thing, because we'll be testing it out a bit. Obviously, the damage on that's still pretty lame, but hey, whatever. Now, depending on how many Q switches you hook up, it'll fire more rapidly, as one would suspect. But anyway, this will not do anything just by itself, this because it's not going to be able to detect any enemy missiles. That is what the missile warners are from. Now, in order to build the missile warner system, you need an AI core here. You need an AI mainframe. I also hooked it up to a couple of card slots with the association, aimpoint selection, and target prioritization. Didn't really need to do these, but I did it anyway. I also put a wireless transmitter on top of it that allows it to connect to the other parts we assembled. Over here, I set up a wireless receiver, which receives the signal from the mainframe and transmits it to the device itself. and a couple of six-point connectors. At the top of which I've put these missile warners. You have to put them facing forward. So if I go into AI, missile warner, you can't place them down, can't place them sideways. You have to place them facing away from whatever you have. Now, these will detect enemy missiles that are about, I think it was half a meter above sea level, if I'm not mistaken, in a hemispherical kind of area of effect. Personally, I would build a tower like this, where I have them pointing every direction, just in case. You could also combine this with something like, say, let me see here, a radar system, or a, where is it, 360-degree tracker. You know, add this to your tower, your AI tower, essentially. Now, when it comes to laser missile defense itself, let me actually raise this up here a bit. I'm going to take some custom cannons, some laser connectors here for a moment. Laser missile defense, and laser missile defense as well. You have to aim it in the direction, just like the missile warner, that you want it to be placed. So we'll place that right there. And let's go into our enemy spawn GUI. And we're going to spawn in an enemy shrike, which is a bomber. A very annoying bomber that you may have discovered, well discovered, may have had to fight before. There it is right there. So the moment that it starts dropping its bombs, which will be right about now, laser missile defense, as you can see, starts shooting down the missiles. And actually did a pretty good job. I don't think a single one of those managed to hit our target, or hit the ship. Now, I can make this even more powerful against that by adding in more of the laser missile defense blocks to this. So just like the missile warner, I could create a little tower of anti-missile defense here. They seem to do a pretty good job, though at range, it seems like they're not doing as good of a job taking down those missiles. So, you definitely want to have multiple of these around your ship if you can, which also makes a good idea to use the laser transceiver system like so to transmit it wherever it's needed. Oh, yeah, it's doing a fabulous job. Oh, one of them hit. So it's not perfect, but it's doing the best it can. To show all of these kind of systems in a work, or in effect, let me go ahead and summon in my little laser ship here. Also, it'll probably destroy that shrike in seconds. Okay, load vehicle. Now, this one I'm going to be summoning in right now is not the finished product. It actually have a bunch of enhancements I've done to it since then. So, this is just what I had previously. I don't even think this has a missile warner. It does have a single missile warner attached, but this was just, that's it. It's really all it has. Now, my laser, as you can see, is just ripping that shrike apart. Now, this ship is not perfect. I also, in the new one, have electric engines to help store power in order to feed this beast with energy. Electric engines are actually quite useful, and I might cover them in a different tutorial, depending. We'll see what happens. Okay, you can stop now, my friend. It's okay. Don't have to attack the salvage. We're good here. We're good here. So this ship essentially takes, let me go into the pontoons on the side here, laser beams produced from either side, transmitted with the Q-switches attached to them here. I could probably add a connector to the very end with some Q-switches, but whatever. It's transmitted to this connector, which then sends both of the beams straight to this lovely multipurpose laser block, which again then sends it up into the turret and C configuration block style connector here to the other transceiver, which then gets sent up to my actual weapon. Now, this system is fairly effective, and I do also have, currently set up on the front only, I also took the laser beam from this, went up, and then sent it straight to the laser, anti-laser defense, well, laser missile defense system right here. So this helps to shoot down anything that will come near us. If I take this down, you can see that even going through all of this wood, the laser beam has no problem. There's no degradation to the power or anything like that. So you don't have to, you know, go out of your way to make the beam extend out like this. Honestly, I probably could actually seal this back in and it wouldn't be a problem. Let's see here. Yep. So I probably should do this actually next time I build the build or go into the game with this. Oh, it looks weird though. Oh, it's because I'm using a double slope, a 2-meter slope. Whatever, it doesn't matter. Regardless, that's a really good way. I just did that to pretty much show a visual line so I could tell exactly where the hell the beam was going. Regardless, this is essentially how you set up both a laser, laser attack system and a laser defense system. So, hopefully you've all enjoyed this lovely little tutorial on the lasers. Hopefully it answered most of your questions about the laser defense systems and general. Here we go. Let's hop up here. Whoop! Custom laser systems itself. If you have any questions about it, feel free to chuck them in the chat or in the chat. In the comment section down below, and I will answer them as I can. Well, actually, one thing I might have almost forgot here. In order to get the most out of your beam cannon, we go to multi-purpose laser here. Five steering optics are the max you'll get for the width of it. If I add a six, actually, no, six. Never mind, six it seems. Yes, six steering optics is the max you can actually do for steering optics. Anything beyond that, you want to take the initial steering optics, add them to the front of your weapon. You then want to add the laser optics in order to increase the accuracy and range of the weapon. There we go. That'll help create one deadly little beam. Anyway, that is essentially how you would want to set up the actual front of this device. But anyway, thank you for watching. Hope you all enjoyed. Have yourselves a great one, and I will see you all another time with some more From the Depths. Peace out, everybody.